Hello, everybody. Dinky Doo, it's just me, Scotty McClure. Now, you won't be expecting me to pop up on a Monday lunchtime, but I thought we'd do a quick eclipse special and one or two things I had to run past you. So if you've just joined us, then a very, very warm welcome. I'll let you get used to the shock and the surprise, and then I'll know when you're there. So what I'll do is I'll just tell you what's happening. We are an eclipse special. I was on last night, of course, 10 o'clock sharp through until 11. Now, I do need to tell you a little bit about the programme from last night. We had a call which interrupted the programme, which means it's in two pieces for transmission. So make sure you see part one and part two of last night's programme. There you are. Excellent stuff. Jackie Flynn, Dinky Doo. Hiya, Scotty, says Jackie. Hi, Jackie, Dinky Doo. From me, Scotty McClure. Now, I know a lot of you will be at your desks grabbing a sandwich. We need to get back to having an hour for lunch and doing proper things in this country. You know, enjoying our food. Hello, big man, says Ron Stewart. Hello, Ron, Dinky Doo. Lovely to have you with us. Scotty McClure, quick Monday pop-up, eclipse special. I want to talk about the eclipse. All right, Scotty, a wee shout-out for my pal Kevin McNally, says Alan Beard. Of course, Alan, Dinky Doo. Good afternoon, Scotty, says Andy McCrory. Good afternoon, Andy. Lovely to have you with us. Scotty McClure saying Dinky Doo, just for you. Now, can I get that periscope to work, says Andrew Thompson. Well, you should do. John Tom says, eclipse. Yes, the big eclipse is happening, John. You should know all about it. Very, very important. A solar eclipse where the moon covers the sun. And, of course, tremendous big, big energy, very, very positive energy out there for a lot of us. Angie, hello, Dinky Doo, says Ron. Glim Loudon, hey, Scotty from Atlanta. Fantastic to have you in Atlanta. If you're watching in America, a very, very good morning to you. I know a lot of you will be getting up and doing the old, you'll be doing this one, don't you? Ah, what time is it? Hey, ah, put the periscope on. Scotty McClure's on the periscope. Dinky Doo. How about that? Fantastic stuff. So there you go. And Angie says, hi, Dinky Doo. Too cloudy for the eclipse here. We'll only see a bit of it, if possible, from 7:40, says Angie. Now, Angie, I'm surprised that we will see any of it over here, but I know it's very, very big in America, and a lot of people have gone to Oregon to see it. So if you're in Canada, if you're in America, the Carolinas, North and South Carolina, I think you should be able to get a swatch at it. Excellent stuff. Afternoon from all the Airdrie taxi drivers, says Jim Clark. Dinky Doo, Jim, to all the Airdrie taxi drivers from Scotty McClure, the world's top broadcaster, saying Dinky Doo, just for you. Now then, we're one big family. Great stuff, says Ron Stewart. We are one big family on Facebook. And of course, there's only one race, the human race. Lovely to have you on with us. Wendy MacDonald Thompson. Good afternoon, Scotty. Good afternoon to you, Wendy. Lovely to have you with us, of course. And welcome to Scotty McClure's Eclipse Special. I'm going to see who we've got in America who's watching the eclipse, who's going to be there for the actual moment. Is there a time difference? So there we know. Great stuff, says Ron. Hello, Scotty. You're looking well. The BBC at 6 o'clock, says George McGlashan. Are you on, George, or am I on, or is the eclipse happening at 6 o'clock? Oh, my cap's a wee bit. I'll just square off my cap for you. I was square off. Did you like that there? Yes, a military expression. Square off caps. So there we are. Michael Spellick says hello. Hello, Michael. Lovely to have you with us. Dinky Doo. You're watching Scotty McClure, the one-stop broadcaster. I'm just off Periscope there. I was doing a quick Periscope. And, of course, if you're on Twitter, you'll see that there's a poll. Would you watch and listen to a Scotty McClure national phone-in? So there you are. That's the next day. I get your cap straight, says Jackie Flynn. I'll set my cap. Set my cap. Remember that one? Oh, I think she's set her cap at him. March and rally in Dunfermline on Saturday, 11:30, says Wendy MacDonald Thompson. What for, Wendy? You must supply some more information so I can tell not just one nation, but every nation watching Scotty McClure right now and saying Dinky Doo. Looking great, Scotty, from Frank in Glasgow. Dinky, Frank, lovely to hear from you. How old are you, says Michael Spalik. I'm of an indeterminate age because I wasn't actually born, you see. I was knitted. My grandmother knitted me. I know she dropped a couple of stitches, but she knitted me, so there you are. So I'm not of any great age. An independence rally, says John Thomas. Aha, independence for Scotland. That will happen, by the way. I am no political animal, as you well know, but I am an economist. And the best thing for the whole economy would be for Scotland to get ahead and go independent. And that's without any shadow of doubt. I can tell you that from an economist's point of view, Scotland needs to be independent. That's its next step. It can't get caught up in the weakness of Westminster politics and the minutiae of all that. Did you say 2 second war, Michael Spalik? 2 second war. What are you on about, Michael? I don't know what you're talking about there, lot. Shared, says Ron Stewart. Oh, very kind of you, Ron. It's a rally called One Future, One Direction, Forward as One, says Wendy MacDonald Thompson. I think that's a very, very good idea. Let's hope it's reported on national and international television that the Scots wish to be independent of Westminster, particularly with this Brexit shambles that's happening at the moment, and that should actually be null and void. So there we are. Jackie's put the link up there for you, events, Facebook events, so you can see it on there, guys. One Future, One Direction, Forward as One. That's the future for Scotland and independence. Scotland should actually be independent now. Anything up to 72% of the people want it. Thank you, Scotty. Have a great day, says Wendy. Dinky do to you. And have you experienced the Second World War, says Michael Spalik. Only through my family. My father was in the Second World War for 6 years. And he was a paratrooper. He was a Cameron Highlander. He was dropped into Nijmegen, Operation Market Garden. He was dropped into Norway at the time of the heavy water. So you'll see that. You'll see a lot of it in a movie called the... what's that movie called? It's a fantastic movie. So there you are. It'll pop back to me. It'll come back to me. I'll get it back. And it's about what was going on in Norway. You'll see it there. Kirk Douglas is in it. The Heroes of Telemark. That's it. Came back to me. I knew it would come back to me. So there you are. And that was very tough. I lost an uncle in the Second World War as well. That was very, very tough. My granny worked in the forge during World War II, making ammo. Absolutely, yes, indeed she would do. Bless her. So there we go. George McGlashan says, shared. Thank you very much. Can everybody share. Scotty McClure's lunchtime broadcast. A quick pop-up, an eclipse special. When people see me coming, they think it's an eclipse. I'll tell you that, so there you are. And, you know, people say I light up a room. I like that, especially if I come away from the window. Right, was it a bridge too far? Yes, absolutely, it was a bridge too far under Major Jack Frost and under General Urquhart. So there you are, General Urquhart, a Scottish gentleman, played in A Bridge Too Far by Sean Connery. There you are, General Urquhart. Can I ask you, what will be in the BBC at 6 o'clock, says Michael Spalik. I think, Michael, they're talking about the eclipse. We'll see what's happening in the eclipse at 6 o'clock. Very, very powerful. Big, big, big energy. I don't know how many of you are interested in all these world energies and in astrology and the astrological setup. You know, do you take note of the stars? Do you take note of the planets? Do you take note of what's happening? Planetary activity. Very, very interesting. So there we are. Aha, thanks, says Michael. Not at all. Absolutely. Can all of you share? We've got some very good numbers here at the moment, guys. Excellent. Tell us a good joke, Scotty. Cheer us up, dinky-doo. William, I went into the doctor's. He examined me. He said, I can't find anything wrong with you, Scotty, but it could be the drink. I said, I'll pop back when you're sober. So there we are. Excellent. BBC headline news won't be war, British treatment of disabled people or austerity. It'll be about Big Ben, says John Thomas. Well, there we are. Well, of course, Big Ben's very important if you're in London, because you're standing going, "Anybody know the time? Dum 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 dum." Pause. Wait. Boy. Boy. Oh, it must be 3 o'clock. There's Big Ben. So there we are. Do you believe NASA protects secret things? Says Michael. Well, I think NASA may have found out one or two things that they think we probably don't want to alarm the populace by sharing all that stuff with them. It's cloudy in Manchester, says Mark Hesford. Mark Hesford, dinky doo to you. Lovely to have you with us. I could see the point if they were pulling it down. It's only stopped for repairs, says Angie. I know, it's quite a fantastic setup. Of course, Big Ben, as you all well know, is not the clock, it's the bell. And there's a crack in it. They got it from the old Whitechapel foundry, and it fell off the wagon when it was being made and got cracked. But they decided, I think they had to recast it. I'm pretty sure they made a new bell, and that got a crack as well. So there you go. You'll need to put your ear protectors on if you're up there. And there's old pennies and halfpennies and things for just keeping it absolutely. They sit the coins on the pendulum if they feel it needs to lose or gain a second, things like that. I mean, some files with aliens. I don't know, do you believe in aliens? You know, somebody said they saw a blue light fly over the Largs to Kilburnie Road one night in Scotland, and I thought, if you're the captain of an alien ship, would you choose the Largs Kilburnie Road? You might do, I don't know. That's up to you guys. Do you believe in aliens? So there we are. Let's find out. Great Scott, says Mark Hesford. I thank you, Mark. That is very kind of you. You are a great mank. Fantastic. Have a good day. Family night shifts or bedtime. Dinky doo. Dinky doo, Ron Stewart. Thank you very much for all your support and all your interest. Have a lovely, lovely day and a great shift. We'll see you later. So excellent stuff. Right. If you've got any comments, do make them. If you want to share, do that as well. Remember, you can get on and watch Scotty McClue on YouTube. So there we are. We just passed the 1,000 mark on YouTube last night. 1,001. Back to work, says John Toms. Absolutely. Get yourself back to work, young man. And you are a credit to the country. When I say the country, I mean Scotland. Now then, it's been a busy show, really got going at the kick-off, says Thomas. Yes, very, very busy, Thomas. Lots to do. The Scotty McClue shows are always very, very busy. Now, last night's show, the 1 hour show on a Sunday night, 10 o'clock sharp, Facebook Live, just for you, one of the world's great broadcast platforms. Make sure you see both parts of it. There's part one and part two. They're uploaded on Facebook, they're uploaded on YouTube, and they're uploaded on Twitter. So you'll get them there. I am from the Czech Republic, you know. Yes, so would I pronounce your name Michal Špalek? Yes, would that be fair? From Czechoslovakia? Excellent, something. The Czech Republic, fantastic. Welcome, 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 I say Michal. Or Michal. Michal. Are you in the Czech Republic right now, Michal? Have I said it right? Is that the way to pronounce it? Yes. Yay, says Michal. Michal Špalek. Lovely. Lovely to have you with us in the Czech Republic. And love to all our Czech Republic brothers and sisters in Europe. Hopefully we won't be leaving you. There's a bit of mucking about at the moment, but hopefully that will calm down. Brexit will be cancelled and we will be staying in Europe. Derek James Michael Wallace Wilson. Hi, Scotty. Hello, Derek James Michael Wallace Wilson. Lovely to have you with us. Fine, thanks, says Michael. And to you, Michael, dinky doo from Scotty McClue. Hands across the sea, I say. Right, it's time you lot were all back to work. So I shall push off. Have a lovely, lovely afternoon. Enjoy the eclipse. Don't be looking at it. Health and safety without the proper eyewear. All right, so there's a warning from McClue. Take care of your dear selves. Dinky doo. Right. I like people like you. Thank you, Michal. We like you. Imagine the uproar if Brexit was cancelled, says Lee Fan. I don't know that there would be an uproar because it was sold to us on a false premise, a lot of duff gen, a lot of fibs, a lot of misconstruing the truth. And you'll notice the main politicians who were responsible for it skedaddled as soon as it happened. They went, oh, we need to get right out of here. And they just took off. So there you are. So there might not be an uproar if we cancelled Brexit. It would only be an email. And I can't see that causing a problem. Can you try and say, aho lidi? It means, hi people. So they are, aho lidi. So there we are. Have I said it right? Michael, you need to tell me, have I said it properly to the good people of the Czech Republic? Right, need to dash, catch up soon. So there we are. There's lots of laughter going on from Michael. So I don't know if I've said it right or wrong. Excellent stuff. But hi to the people of the Czech Republic. Dinky doo from the world's top broadcaster, Scotty McClue. Check me out. Excellent stuff. Nice, says Mikhail. Best video yet. So there we are. Fantastic. Your best video yet is David Davis sweating when he admits food prices will not may rise by 30 to 40%. What does it mean, Dinky Doo? Dinky Doo means is all well with you and the world. It's a Scotty McClue saying. And it goes throughout the world. Dinky-doo is everybody in the world. Dinky-doo. Spread the message, spread the word, share everything. If you want to stick a fiver into GoFundMe, do that. GoFundMe.com/Scotty-McClue. If you want to pop something into PayPal.me/Scotty-McClue, all one word, do that. And if you want to become a patron of Scotty McClue, go to Patreon or patreon.com and / Scotty McClue. Excellent stuff. I will see it in school. XD. XD to you. Dinky doo, everybody. Scotty McClue, do you want me to sing you the song? Why not? Goodbye, everybody. Goodbye. Take care, everybody, as you go. Goodbye, everybody. Of winter saying au revoir and a cheerie. Oh, have a lovely afternoon, guys. Go and follow Scotty McClue on YouTube and subscribe. Scotty McClue has left the building. Dinky-doo.